Travis Kelce hugs mom Andrea Swift and dances to Taylor Swift's music at the second concert in Indianapolis. On Saturday, November 2nd, Travis Kelce attended his girlfriend Taylor Swift's concert in Indianapolis. Travis Kelce, dressed in a black long-sleeved shirt and midnight rodeo cap, holds hands with girlfriend Taylor Swift as they walk toward the exit of Lucas Oil Stadium after the end of Night 2 of the Eras Tour. Travis Kelce had just appeared at a Chiefs practice, however. He made a surprise appearance at girlfriend Taylor Swift's concert. This was Kelce's 14th appearance on the Eras Tour since he and Swift went public with their relationship. He has not been to a concert since Night 2 in Gelsenkirchen, Germany. Kelce will rest before Monday night's football game at Arrowhead Stadium against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Travis Kelce's support for Taylor Swift surprised and delighted fans at Lucas Oil Stadium, Indy. "Welcome to the acoustic," Swift said in a low-key orange, white and blue fishnet dress to 69,000 fans. She performed a mashup of The Prophecy from The Tortured Poets Department and This Love from 1989, Taylor's version. On the piano, Swift performed Maroon from Midnights and Cowboy Like Me from Evermore. Her final show on the American Eras Tour was Sunday night in Indy. She will wrap up the tour on November 8th in Vancouver, Canada, before she resumed her Eras Tour concert. Taylor Swift has been making headlines with her outfits in Kansas City Chiefs games and date night looks with Travis Kelce. During the US leg of her tour, she continues to do the same. As Swift took over the second day of the Eras Tour in Indianapolis, the music sensation surprised the audience with a stunning new look as she stepped onto the stage. Fans buzzed with excitement at Lucas Oil Stadium when the 34-year-old pop star kicked off the show with an electrifying performance. Starting the set from her Lover era, Swift mesmerized the Indianapolis audience with her glitzy red bodysuit and matching red boots. Adding to the spectacle, she took the stage with her signature pink Lover guitar. However, what truly captured the attention of the fans was Swift's stunning new hairstyle. Various posts on X mentioned the singer's new look, particularly her bangs, which the fans clearly adored. "Her bangs are so cute," one wrote, while another expressed the same thought and said, "The bangs are here forever." A user poked fun at the Bad Blood singer and commented, "Taylor Swift's bangs are shorter than her relationships." A fan also mentioned, "Taylor, you were supposed to be growing out your bangs," while another wrote, "Who is her hairstylist? Because I need to go wherever she goes." In addition to her head-turning outfits, another trademark of Swift is her evolving bangs. From wispy to sideswept to blunt cuts, her hairstyles have changed over the years, like the full blunt look she showcased on the second day of the Eras Tour. Speaking of her world tour, Travis Kelce's girlfriend is currently in the final leg of her tour in the US. The award-winning artist will wrap up the Eras Tour on December 8, 2024, in Vancouver, British Columbia, marking the 152nd and final concert. The Chiefs versus the Bucks is only hours away now, long hours, for sure, and the Arrowhead cannot be more ready, is what many would think, especially with the 7-0 perfect start. But hold your horses. Trouble's brewing, and it comes wrapped in injury reports. And the 35-year-old Travis Kelce is left, yet again, to soldier on the offense, being the perfect mate to Patrick Mahomes off the field and on it. Travis' increase in load comes after his fellow TE Jared Wiley went down with a knee injury during Friday's practice. And the hearsay is that it might be a serious one. When the news broke first, Andy Reid had not stood behind the podium on Saturday to explain what this meant for the squad, considering this was not the first. Let's not forget, this is the second tight end the Chiefs have lost this week after Jody Fortson tore his ACL against the Raiders. That came as a bummer, considering he was doing bits on his return, and he did not have it easy. Before the injury slid in, he hit 3 targets and 1 reception for 5 yards over 3 games. But that's football. As for the Chiefs, well, it's looking really tight in the tight end room. And that's what makes Wiley's injury look even worse. The 24-year-old had a chance, with Fortson out, to cover for Travis Kelce, one of the best TEs in the league. Instead, all eyes and ears were on Reed's presser to know his update. And guess what? The HC broke the news that the young tight end tore his ACL. Ah. SHT, here we go again. The famous GTA meme comes to mind in these situations. With that, we can say that this rules him out of the MNF clash. And it's a no-brainer. So, these injuries mean it all falls on the Chiefs number 15 and number 87. Linking together how they do. But it should not be as big of a problem as it seems at first glance. Mahomes and Kelce have always had this unspoken connection, one that even makes defenders shake their heads. A couple of things made us write that. Hear me out. The defensive troubles that the Bucks have so glaringly displayed in the past weeks, coupled with Travis Kelce slowly returning to his vintage form. And last, but not least, we've got Andy Reid, whose power of friendship mantra has worked wonders for this QBTE duo. As Chiefs safety Justin Reid said of Kelce, he'll sometimes change his route on the fly. Just gets open. Him and 15 have that connection, and it is impossible to guard. Honestly, this pair might be the closest thing we've seen to a Tom Brady, Rob Gronk chemistry since the Patriots' glory days. In their time together, Kelce has racked up 7,638 yards and 54 touchdowns in 100 games with Mahomes. That's more than just stats, it's a testament to their in-sync playmaking. And it brews from their off-the-field tight-knit bond. Now, let's talk Bucks defense. The Falcons, Ravens, and Saints have all managed to expose gaps in the middle of the field. And tight ends? Yeah, they are the ones to have found some room to operate. If recent games are any hint, Tampa Bay might have their hands full trying to contain Travis. The Bucks are allowing the third most receiving yards to tight ends this season. And Kelce's 103.8 yards per game against them doesn't make that job easier. So, that night will be all about stopping number 87 because there's no one else left for them to lay out game plans for. If Kelce gets rolling, Tampa's D might be left gasping for air. And sitting at 4-4, they cannot afford to slip up any further. What do you think? Are you hedging your bets for another Travis masterclass like we saw in Las Vegas in Week 8? The Kansas City Chiefs have suffered a long list of injuries in the first half of the 2024 season, and a new midweek injury has delivered another blow to the Chiefs' offensive weaponry. Rookie tight end Jared Wiley was listed as a limited participant in Friday's practice due to a knee injury that had not been previously designated, providing cause for concern that the 24-year-old fourth-round pick had suffered an injury at practice. On Saturday, Chiefs head coach Andy Reid confirmed that Wiley suffered a season-ending ACL tear during Friday's practice. Jared Wiley, at practice, tore his ACL, Reid said. Non-contact, it's one of those freak things. So, he'll go through that whole process. Practice squad tight end Peyton Hendershot will be brought up and he'll work in there. He's been taking reps and he's played before, so he'll be okay. The rookie's injury comes just days after tight end Jody Fortson suffered a season-ending knee injury against the Las Vegas Raiders. Now, the Chiefs' two healthy active roster tight ends are Travis Kelce and Noah Gray, with Hendershot on the practice squad. The Chiefs traded for Hendershot from the Dallas Cowboys for a conditional 7th-round pick just before the NFL's roster cutdown deadline and waived him less than a month later. Then, KC was able to bring Hendershot back on the practice squad where he's been since. Without Wiley and Fortson, Hendershot will be promoted for Monday night's game and could be signed to the active roster as KC's new number 3 tight end. Wide receiver Juju Smith-Schuster did not practice on Saturday, completing his second consecutive week without seeing the practice field, leaving him sidelined for the second consecutive game. Reid officially ruled Smith-Schuster out for Monday's game against the Buccaneers.